students, in our previous class we already discussed about ionic bond, what are the primary requirements for the formation of that bond, how that bond is formed. We take various examples for that, and we also discuss the properties of ionic bonded solid. Today we will discuss another type of bond, that is covalent bond. That is covalent bond. At the very beginning, you should know how this type of bond is formed and what is the cause behind it. In case of covalent bonding, that is mainly formed in between two non-metals. In ionic bond, what we see, the bond is formed in between metal and non-metal. But in covalent bonding, bond is formed between two non-metals. That means it is clear that is not formed by giving and gaining of electrons. If we consider two number of chlorine atoms, here one chlorine atom, here another chlorine atom, if we take. In case of chlorine atom, in the outermost shell, the number of electrons are 7, and here also it is 7. But it required one electron, it required also one electron. And if this chlorine gives one electron to this chlorine, no doubt this chlorine will fulfill its octet. But what is about this? In its outermost shell, the number of electrons will be 6. It is unable to fulfill its octet. It is unable to get the stability. For that, why this chlorine atom will give one electron to this chlorine? For that, if they try to fulfill their octet, only one possibility is there. If this chlorine and this chlorine give one electron, and both of these chlorine share this pair of electrons, then this chlorine and this chlorine can fulfill its octet and can get the stability. That is nothing but partner type business. This chlorine try to fulfill its octet. This chlorine also try to fulfill its octet. Now this chlorine gives one electron, this chlorine gives one electron, and both of these chlorine atoms share this pair of electrons. As a result, both can fulfill their octet and can get the chemical. How is this possible? See here, if this chlorine gives one electron, and this chlorine gives one electron, and both of these chlorine share this pair of electrons, then this chlorine fulfills its octet, that chlorine also fulfills its octet. How? They can share like this way, and get the stability and can form Cl2 molecule This type of bond, which is formed by the sharing of electrons, donated by one, taken by one. Here what we see, donated by both, shared by both. Donated by both, shared by both. Here the bond is formed by the sharing of electrons. For that, the bond strength is not so high like ionic bond, because sharing is there. Here the bond is weak. Here the bond will be weak bond, weak type of bond. Not so strong like ionic bond. Like this, hydrogen H2 can form. Like this, Br2, I2, F2 can form. Like this, some compound also may be formed, such as HCl, HBr, HI, HF, by this sharing of electrons. That is mainly formed in between two non-metal, in between two non-metal. If we consider the number of bond formed, if we consider the number of bond formed, then covalent bond is mainly divided into three parts, that is single bond, double bond, triple bond. Three parts are there by considering the number of bond present, that is single bond, second is double bond, and the third is triple bond. Single bond, double bond, triple. If we consider this Cl2, here one electron we are getting from this chlorine, one electron we are getting from this chlorine. As a result, it will form the bond, and all of you know, which I already discussed in various classes, that bond is nothing but a pair of electrons. Here, a pair of electrons will take part in bond formation. For that, the bond which will be there, that is single bond, that is single bond. Cl. Single bond will be there. If we consider two different type of element, such as one carbon and the four other is hydrogen. Carbon in the outermost shell, the number of electrons are four. If it join with one hydrogen by sharing one electron, one hydrogen sharing of electron, one hydrogen sharing of electron, and another hydrogen sharing of electron, then here what we see, four number of bonds are present, but all are single bond. By these two electron form one single bond, by these two electron another single bond, by these two electron another single bond, by these two electron another single bond. So all these are our single bond. But if we consider any atom where we see that they are sharing their electron by two, one atom gives two number of electron, another atom gives two number of electron, and by this way they fulfill their octet, then the bond which is formed, that is our double bond. That is our double bond. If we consider oxygen, in oxygen, outermost shell, the number of electrons are 6. If we consider another oxygen atom, here also in the outermost shell, the number of electrons are 6. It is also 6. It is also 6. Now, if both these oxygen try to fulfill their octet,
Then here what we see in the outermost shell, the number of electron is 6. It require another 2 electron to fulfill its octet. If we consider this oxygen, here what we see, 6 number of electrons are present and it require another 2 electron to fulfill its octet. Now, if this oxygen gives 2 number of electron and this oxygen gives 2 number of electron, and both of these oxygen share the pair of electron, if both of these oxygen share the pair of electron, then what we see, that can fulfill their octet and can get the stability, and can get the stability. Here, if we consider this oxygen, that is fulfill their octet. If we consider this oxygen, that is also fulfill its octet. That is also fulfill its octet. Here, 2 number of electron will join with each other and will form a bond. And these 2 electron will join with each other and will form a bond. So then, what we will see, oxygen, single bond, oxygen. By this way, they will form O2, which is stable. By this way, they will form oxygen molecule, that is O2, and get the stability. And here the covalent bond which we are getting, that is double bond. Here it is single bond and here it is double bond. If we take 2 different elements, here also one is carbon and the other is hydrogen. In case of carbon, there we are considering 2 number of carbon and 4 number of hydrogen. One join with hydrogen, another join with hydrogen, this join with hydrogen, this join with hydrogen, another two electron. Now, this carbon here, what we see? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 number of electron. Here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 number of electron. And both of these carbon required another 2 number of electron to fulfill its octet. As a result, they will share with each other. And here also we will get carbon, carbon double bond. Hydrogen, that is our ethene, or ethylene. Here also double bond is formed. This is methane, chlorine, ethene and oxygen. In both the cases, double bond are present. Now, if we consider another one element, that is nitrogen. In case of nitrogen, there are 5 number of electron in its outermost shell. There what we see? 5 number of electron in its outermost shell. It requires 3 number of electron to fulfill its octet. These also require 3 number of electron to fulfill its octet. Now, if this nitrogen gives 3 number of electron and this nitrogen gives 3 number of electron and form their bond, then both of these nitrogen will get the stability and can fulfill its octet. So how we will get this bond? Bond is nothing but a pair of electron. One bond, second bond, third bond. Nitrogen, by this way what we are getting? N2. By this way what we are getting? N2. It is a stable molecule. So this is our example of triple bond. This is single bonded compound, double bonded compound, triple bonded compound. we can get triple bond by using two number of element also. We take another example, that is, if we consider two number of carbon, and here one hydrogen present, then this carbon require another 3 electron to fulfill its octet. This carbon require another 3 electron to fulfill its octet. As a result, they will join with each other by the formation of bond. And here what we see, the bond is like 1, 2, 3, C, H, C, H. Product is C2H2. The name of this compound is ethyne. The name of this compound is ethyne, and the nickname of this compound is acetylene. Acetylene. Here, what we are getting? Triple bond. We already discussed single bond, double bond, triple bond with example and how this type of bond is formed. How this type of bond is formed. You just take the screenshot of this or note it down, and after that I will rub it. Now, as per polarity, covalent bond is again divided into two parts. What I am saying? As per polarity, covalent bond is again divided into two parts. Number one, polar covalent bond and the second is our non-polar polar covalent bond and non-polar covalent bond. Now, this polar covalent bond, what is this type of bond? Now, in case of this type of bond, polarity will develop. In case of this type of bond, polarity will develop. What do you mean by polarity? Though these are covalent bonds, there will be no such positive charge and negative charge is there, because they are neither giving nor gaining of electrons. Then also, little bit positive charge and little bit negative charge may be formed in case of covalent bond, which we denote as delta plus, delta minus, which is a very, very little amount of positive charge and very, very little amount of negative charge. But some amount of charge will be produced, that is our polarity, and due to this polarity, the covalent bond which is formed, that is our polar covalent bond, that is our polar covalent bond. If we consider an example, hydrogen and chlorine. If we consider hydrogen in the outermost shell, the number of electron is only one. The number of electron is only one. In case of chlorine, the number of electron is 7. It requires another one electron to fulfill its octet. Hydrogen require another one electron to fulfill its duplet. Duplet means two. If it will take another one electron, then it will get the structure of helium, which is also inert gas and will get the stability due to inert gas configuration. In case of chlorine, it requires another one electron. For that, this chlorine gives one electron and this hydrogen gives one electron, and both of these chlorine and hydrogen share this pair of electrons, But here hydrogen will give one electron, chlorine will give electron one. Both of these share this pair of electron. So the pair of electrons should be at the middle. But chlorine is much more electronegative in comparison to hydrogen, which we already discussed in periodic table that there are 6 number of electronegative elements are present in our periodic table: fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, oxygen, nitrogen. Chlorine is much more electronegative. And what is electronegativity? Electronegativity is that property of an element by which it attracts shared pair of electron towards itself. Chlorine is electronegative. For that, this shared pair of electron will be shifted towards chlorine. Then what will be the position? Hydrogen, chlorine, this pair of electron is shifted towards chlorine. As a result, the electron density of chlorine will be high. Whereas this pair of electron is shifted from hydrogen, for that the electron density in case of hydrogen will be less. Here electron density is less, here electron density is high. As a result, it will be little bit positive and it will be little bit negative. This is slightly positive, for that this is delta plus. Slightly positive, or you can say partially positive, for that this we are writing delta plus and this we are writing delta minus. Though these are covalent bond, then also the polarity will be developed due to this electronegative element. This type of bond is known as our polar covalent bond. This type of bond is known as our polar covalent bond. And when we will take the aqueous solution of this type of bonded compound, then it can form cation and anion and can conduct electricity. For that, here we see polarity will develop, and this type of bond is known as our polar covalent bond. What is our nonpolar covalent bond? In case of nonpolar covalent bond, there what we see, electronegativity difference is very less. For there, no shifting of electron will be there. If there is no such shifting of electron, then no polarity will develop. And that type of bond is known as our nonpolar covalent bond, which is formed in our chlorine, bromine, hydrogen, oxygen. Here what we see, electronegativity difference is either zero or will be very less. For that, no such polarity will develop. And if there no such polarity will develop, then this type of bond is nonpolar covalent bond. Today, up to this, the next part we will discuss in the next class. Okay, students, thanks a lot.